Isang mapagpalang Martes na umaga po sa ating lahat. So for this morning, I am going to talk about this very important topic. So the topic is Keeping Students Engaged, a Practical Guide for Teachers. So maybe the teachers who are listening right now, I believe po, we already know the theories, the concept, yan, yung mga ganyang bagay. I believe na matutunan nyo na po siya sa mga previous Vival webinars and other webinars. So ang maibabahagi ko po sa inyo yung mga karanasan ko, my experience in handling online classes. So recently po, in my school, in our school, which is in Pasig, so sinabi nga kanina, nagsimula na po kami ng online classes last August 17. So, let me share lang po a brief background kung saan manggagaling yung itatopic ko ngayon. So, nagsimula na po kami ng online classes last week. So, isang linggo na po ang nakakalipas ng magturo kami online sa aming mga estudyante. So, the thing is, it is quite challenging talaga to teach online. Siyempre, nandito po tayo, nandito ko sa bahay, tapos nasa iba't ibang lugar yung mga estudyante ko. And ang tanong na nag-pop sa isip ko is, how do I keep my students engaged? Yes, their cameras are turned on. They are muted though. I can see them from another device. Yes, they reply via chat box, reactions, or by clicking the raise hand button. But my next question is, how do I make sure that my students are still engaged? How do I ensure that they are participating genuinely? So, background lang po ulit, I am teaching grade 1 for this school year. So, imagine a teacher teaching 21 grade 1 students in the morning, then another grade 1 students in the afternoon. So, sa mga nakalipas na online classes, ang dami ko rin na-realize and na-experience na gusto kong ibahagi sa inyo. So again, ang scope ng topic ko, the scope of this webinar is basically during online synchronous classes. So online classes lamang po. So whether you are using Teams, Google Meet, or Zoom, or kung ano pa bang programs. So again, the context, the scope, and limitation of this topic is mainly during online synchronous classes. So the question is, how do we keep our students engaged during online synchronous classes? Siguro tayo, teachers, whenever we are attending the meetings, we are not that required to turn on our cameras. Minsan nga nakahiga nga ako during while meeting. So ngayon, paano natin gagawin na hindi tayo karamihin at ibalik ng students natin yun? So yun yung isi-share ko sa inyo. So today, we are going to talk about practical tips. What are the things that you need to do before your online classes and during online classes and after online classes? So again, yung context lang nito ay nasa online synchronous classes. And then later on, I will share with you some icebreakers that or some strategies that you can use for online distance learning. Ang pinakamagandang feature po siguro ng topic na ito is kung meron kayong notebook and pens, please take notes. Take note of the icebreakers and strategies kasi sobrang magagamit niyo po ito and later, kukwento ko pa ng marami. So, there again, share ko sa inyo ang practical tips to keep your students engaged. So, imagine this. I am going to give you a scenario. What if mamaya, or maybe tomorrow, start na ng online class nyo. Online class. So whether you are teaching in private or in public school, what if lang bukas na yung online classes? And you need to prepare your PowerPoint. Yung PowerPoint na i-share nyo. Share screen, gano'n. Tapos, paano ka makakasigurado na hindi magiging passive lang yung mga estudyante? Paano mo sila i-encourage na maging active sa klase. Ano yung unang-una mong gagawin? So before your first online class, the very first thing that you should do is to establish your identity as a teacher. Grabe naman yan, Miss Bella. Akala ko ba ang ibibigay mo sa akin, practical tips, eh ano yung identity as a teacher? Kasi ganito nga po yun. Lahat ng activities, lahat ng strategies, lahat ng icebreakers na gagawin natin, eh nakaangkula po ito sa personality natin, identity natin as a teacher. But here is a very important reminder that you need to know. So, if merong important na bagay na, kung meron kayong dapat tandaan sa topic na ito, ito yung teacher. More than the technology itself, your personality, my dear teacher, matters more. Isa yan sa mga napagnilayan ko sa mga previous online classes namin. Yes, I can prepare a very comprehensive, creative PowerPoint. But at the end of the day, what matters most is my personality and my identity as a teacher, as a caring teacher to my students. Here's the thing, teachers. You have to let your students know that who are they meeting is not just a virtual teacher. Hindi ka lang basta-basta virtual teacher na makikita nila sa isang kahon sa screen nila. You are more than that, teachers. Remember that you are always capable to teach, you are capable to empathize, and you are capable to establish your personality as a teacher in this new normal. Remember that, teachers. Woohoo! So, you are not just a virtual teacher, but you are an authentic teacher. A teacher, rather. So let your students know that. Also, teachers, the first 5 minutes of your online classes is the most crucial. So us, in our school, we are only given 30 minutes for each online synchronous class. So sa 30 minutes na yun, yung first meeting namin, I had to let my students know who is their teacher, kung sino ba ako. What kind of teacher ako sa kanila. So, sa first 5 minutes, I have to establish that. So, make sure, teachers, na sa first 5 minutes pa lang ng online classes nyo, na-establish na kung sino ka. Okay? So, pagnilayan po natin yan. What kind of teacher are you? Virtual lang ba or an authentic one? So that is number one, establish your identity. The second one is, after mong magpakilala sa isang online class setup, orient your students about your online classroom rules. What do you want them to do? How would they do it? Yes, of course, your school will give you a general guideline about how to manage your class online. But at the end of the day, you will still have a personalized attack on that general guidelines. So if you are given a general guideline, how will you personalize that na magiging swak sa personality mo at sa klase ng online class na gusto mong i-establish? Now, you have to inform your students. What should they do if they want to speak? What should they turn on? Should they turn on their cameras all the time? Or if my challenge sa internet connection, okay lang ba sa'yo to turn off their cameras? It's up to you. So if you were to ask me, Mies, kasi we all know naman na out of control na yung internet connection sa Pilipinas. Ano yun pa, malalaman ko pa rin ba kung nandun sila sa klase ko kahit naka-mute sila, kahit nakapatay yung kanan? Yes naman, teachers. So, yung gagawin? Give them the chance to provide meaningful answer. O, heto na. Sa amin kasi, I always ask my students to turn on their camera. Pero hindi naman sa lahat ng pagkakataon, lahat ng bata ay blessed na magkaroon ng malakas na internet connection. Kaya, at yung data, diba? Ang lakas kumain ng data ng online classes. So, okay lang siguro. Okay lang. Ipapatay yung camera, ipamute yung mic. Paano natin malalaman kung nakikinig pa sila? Lagi nyo silang tanungin. So, ito nga ang challenge doon. Marami kayong naririnig na mga apps na pwedeng gamitin to assess the learning of your students. But at the end of the day, another data na naman yun. So, ano yung mas economically friendly na paraan na pwede mong gamitin para ma-ensure na nandiyan pa sila? Gamitin mo yung chat box. Sa amin, sa klase namin, kahit grade 1 pa sila, sa orientation, tinuruan na sila na gumamit ng chat box. So, for example, I have a question. May choices lang na A or B. They just have to type A, their answer is A, or if their answer is B, just type B. So, alam niyo yun, sa simpleng multiple choice lang, nagamit niyo na yung chat box na sumagot pa sila at alam niyo na nandun sila. So, teachers, kung nandun pa rin kayo at nakikinig, how can you maximize the use of chat box? Maaari na pwede silang tulungan ng parents to answer. Okay lang yun. Kasi since nga online distance learning, we need to collaborate with their parents. It's okay. Kasi it's still learning. May learning pa rin doon. Imagine, tinuruan mo na, tapos tinuruan pa ng parents beside them. It's still a learning. It's still a form of learning. So, again, how do you maximize the use of chat box? Always, always remind the students that you are recording their answers. So, how would you record their answers? Ito, teacher, ginagawa ko to. So, meron akong notebook. Tapos sa notebook na yon, merong listahan ng mga students. And then, sa bawat pangalan ng students, pag nagre-recite sila, pag sumasagot sila ng mga importanteng tanong, sinecheck ko na nakasagot sila. So, pag merong student na nawawala-wala, so, tatawag ko na yan. Oh, what is your answer? Ganyan. So, lagi niyong tawagin ang pangalan nila. And that is the tip number 4. Lagi niyo silang tawagin sa pangalan. So, balik tayo sa scenario. Online class mo na bukas. So, alam mo na yung personality mo. Alam mo na yung identity mo as a teacher. Sige, na-establish mo na yon. Pangalawa, meron ka ng classroom online rules. Meron ka ng pa-poster. Meron ka ng poster from Canva na nagawa na dapat laging ganito, laging ganyan, etc., etc. Okay, nagawa mo na yon. Tapos, during your online classes, ayun na, magpakilala ka na. Nabasa mo na sa kanila yung gusto mong mangyari. Tapos, nagagamit mo naman na yung chat box, blah, 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 to, call niyo naman, tawagin mo sila by name. Ngayon, meron akong 21 grade 1 students sa umaga. So, imagine, 21 students sa umaga and I only have 30 minutes to conduct my online synchronous class. So, what should I do to give everyone a chance to speak? So, that's the challenge. So, again, I refer to my notebook, to my handy-dandy notebook. I list their names. 5, 5, 5. Class number 1 to 5, 6 to 10, 11 to 15, and so on. Ngayon, katulad nga ng sinabi ko kanina, tinatawag ko sila randomly. Pag may hindi pa nagsasalita, tatawagin ko. Or pwede nyo rin gamitin ang wheel of names. Kaya lang, kapag nag-insert pa tayo ng another website sa ating PowerPoint, that will consume some minutes. Kasi going to another website, minuto na naman yon. Maaaring yung pinapakita yung graphics, videos, matagal mag-load sa end ng student. Diba? Medyo it takes time talaga. So again, the easiest way, the most economical way to let everyone speak is to call them by their names. So randomly, check mo lang pag tapos mo. Pag hindi pa, tawagin mo ulit.
Ganun.
Tapos ano pa? So ito, maisingit ko lang. Make sure that your PowerPoint is magaan lang. I mean, less yung GIFs, less yung videos. Kung may video man, very short na lang. Kasi pwede naman natin ipanood yung video asynchronously. So kung may audio, pwede mag-insert ng ganon. Kaya lang kasi medyo mabigat nga siya sa ano, sa data. At saka halimbawa sa PowerPoint mo, merong video sa end niya, pwedeng mag-lag yung video. Ito based on my experience to, kasi minsan kahit gaano kabilis yung internet, pwede pa rin pala talaga na iba pa yung naka-present na PowerPoint kay student sa naka-present sa akin. So make sure na during your online synchronous classes, meron kang gadget pang monitor ng nangyayari sa class at meron kang gadget or device na ginagamit mo to operate your PowerPoint. So wala lang, that's another thing. Make your PowerPoint simple, magaan. So there, balik tayo. So next thing to keep your students engaged is to maximize the use of intrinsic motivation. So what? There are two kinds of motivation. First is intrinsic, ito yung manggagaling sa student. And next is extrinsic. So ito na yung ano, from the environment person. So let's start with intrinsic motivation. What is intrinsic motivation? So ano lang, teachers, kayo yung paraan kung paano madi-discover ng student yung why nila. Let your students know their why. Let your students discover the purpose of their education through your subject. What outcome should they learn at the end of your class? What is the most basic thing or skill that they should acquire after your class? So you have to reiterate that. What, why? Let them ask their why. Alam niyo ba, kahit sa lower grades, possible yan. So, you just ask the students, why do you think are we learning this? So, kaninang umaga, ang lesson namin is polite words. So, I can motivate my students by asking them, first thing, na why do you think are we learning this? So, again, you have the power to let your students discover the purpose of their education gamit ang subject mo. So, I believe kahit ang tinuturo mo ay algebraic expression, may purpose yan eh. It's still functional in this modern world. So ngayon, let your students discover their reason for studying. That is for intrinsic motivation. So next is extrinsic motivation. So maybe you have heard this before, but I just want to remind you na you can always celebrate your students' small wins. So, pag sinabi natin na recognition, hindi naman necessary na bonggang-bonggang achievement ng bata bago natin i-recognize. You know what? Pwede tayong mag-declare ng recognition day at the end of the week in order to celebrate our students' achievements. So, for example, you've noticed that they have completed the online classes within the week. Then you may give them digital badges or certificates. Now, how should we implement this thing? So, paano natin gagawin yung digital badges or certificates? There are ready-made certificates in Canva that you may use. So, edit-edit na lang, tanggal-tanggal sa mga hindi kailangan. Then, you may share it at the end of your online class. So maybe yung natitirang 5 minutes ng class mo, you can still use it to celebrate your students' small win. So for example, kung meron kang 15 students sa isang online class, tapos i-share mo yung ano mo, yung certificate nila, 15, o i-ano mo lang yun, i-share mo lang sa screen nila. Tapos you ask your students, oh, you can take a screenshot of this part para lang mag-get nila yung certificate nila. Makuha nila yung certificate nila or digital badge nila. Tapos, teachers, ganito pa. Pwede niyong gamitin extrinsic motivation to in this way. So, pwede niyong sabihin na, oh, kung sino man yung makakollect ng 10 digital badges, ganito yung mangyayari. Kung sino yung makareceive ng ganitong digital certificates, ganito yung mangyayari. Kung sino yung makakatanggap ng digital trophy, ito naman yung reward niya. So, yun, yung feeling ng bata na hindi lang siya nag-burden ng mga lesson, ng mga assessment, ng mga worksheet, hindi niya mararamdaman na parang nakakapagod, parang nakakatamad. Kasi alam niya na nare-recognize niyo, teachers, yung pinaghihirapan niya. So again, ang context po nito ay during online synchronous classes. So, katulad sa usual classroom setup, let your students feel that they belong. So again, let your students feel that they belong, na hindi sila nag-iisa. Or hindi sila, alam niyo yun, hindi sila loner lang sa online class na, alam niyo yun, yung nag-join lang sa online class, tapos natapos yung online class na hindi nagsasalita, hindi nagpaparamdam, hindi nagpapakita, hindi man lang nagtatanong. Yung mga may ganung bagay. So again, let your students feel that they belong. So, marami tayong teknolohiya na pwedeng gamitin, na pwedeng gawin. Pero at the end of the day, kung paano ka maging compassionate sa mga students mo, yun yung maaalala nila. So, there. So, if you need to remember something again from this talk, ito yun. Yan. Yung una at saka ito. Next, use icebreakers. Ito na nga. Icebreakers are strategies that you may include in your PowerPoint in order to make sure that your students are still engaged. So, alam niyo yun? So, imagine, for example, ako yung students. Online class na, nakaganito lang ako. Kasi sa teachers, at si teacher kasi, ano lang eh, more talk lang eh. Salita lang ng salita, ganyan-ganyan. Turn off ko na lang kaya yung camera ko, tapos pretend na lang ako na, ano, nakikinig, ganyan-ganyan. So, ito yung challenge. Gumamit tayo ng icebreaker. Ito nga, teachers, ang sinasabi ko kanina. Kapag gumamit tayo ng another website for our icebreaker, it will consume time, it will consume data. But I am not saying na, I am not discouraging you to use that. Ngayon, ang gagamit, meron kayong option, teachers. So, option na yung application, option na yung programs. Ngayon, meron din kayong option to use materials or not to use materials. With or without materials, meron bang technology, meron bang app? So, ayan. So, again, remember, if you need to screenshot something from this talk, ito yun. Sige na, bibigyan ko kayo ng time to screenshot. Okay, tapos na. So, ito na yung icebreakers na dapat nyong, na pwede nyong gamitin. So, mag-start tayo sa grade school. Sa grade school, pwede kang magpa-icebreaker kahit walang material. So, teacher, kung naghahanap ka ng activity na una mong ilalagay pagkatapos ng classroom rules, ito yon. Number one is virtual charades. So, alam niyo yung charades, pwedeng ang topic, pwedeng may topic na person, place, thing, tapos ipapahula mo sa students kung ano yung ina-act out mo. Yung mga ganon. So, pwedeng ikaw yung unang mag-charade, tapos you ask your students to comment ano yun, or pwede ka na rin mag-assign ng student. So, example, naka-turn off lahat ng camera nila. You call a random student and ask them if private message mo, tapos ipa-charade mo yung isang bagay, isang object, isang topic. Icebreaker na yun. Pero make sure yung icebreaker mo ay hindi lalagpas na 10 minuto. Kasi kung isang oras yung class mo, tapos na-consume na yung first 10 minutes, medyo ano na yun, sayang naman yung oras. So, virtual charades. Number two, this or that. Yung this or that, ina-activate niya yung decision making ng students. So for example, in an English class, nag-storytelling ka, and then aside from directly asking your students, aside from directly asking the students some questions about the story, ganyan, you can give them an option. This, is this the character or that is the character? So, alam niyo yun, kumbaga, natatanong niyo na yung basic question, pero hindi niyo sila direktang tinanong. Alam niyo yun, this is another way of checking their comprehension. So, next. So, for example, nasa English class ka pa din. Tapos na kayo sa storytelling. And gusto mo nang itanong yung mga, alam niyo yun, yung mga questions sa story na hindi na who, what, when, where. So, pwede niyo gamitin yung pangatlong icebreaker or strategy na would you rather. So, for example, would you rather give this story a happy ending or not? Would you rather be the main character or not? Would you rather this or that or blah, blah, blah? So, alam niyo yun, yung ganong question pala is a good strategy na to check the comprehension of your students. And, eto na. Another icebreaker for grade school students, pwede rin naman to sa higher teachers, nasa pagdadala niyo naman. Another icebreaker is, what is inside the box? So, hinango ko to sa mga nagpapahula online. So, di ba? Meron silang mga box. So, for example, so I have here a box. Then I will show it to my students. And then I will give them the descriptions about the thing inside the box. So, kung ang lesson ko ay adjectives, nagagamit ko na yung lesson namin about adjectives, di ba? Indirectly. So, for example, this thing is short, it is white, it is long. O, sige nga kayo mga viewers, mahuhulaan nyo kaya ang laman ng box na ito. So, game. I'm giving you 1 minute to guess. What is inside this box? It is essential. It is related to technology. I always use it for my phone. It is long. It is white. So, teachers, what do you think is inside the box? Sige nga. Mag-comment nga po kayo. So, sige na. I-open ko na. So, maybe mag-set lang kayo ng time kung gaano kahaba nyo siya tatanungin or kung ilang items ba yung nasa kahon. Diba? Hindi naman pwedeng buong araw natin ito gawin. So, what's inside the box is a charger. O, diba? So, alam nyo yun, pwede nyo rin siyang ipagawa sa students, okay? Hindi lang kayo. So, bukod sa pagiging icebreaker, pwede rin itong maging strategy. So, for example, sa isang grade 3 class, may adjective kayo na lesson. For your performance task, maybe you can ask them to describe the thing or the object na ilalagay nila sa box. O, sige nga, Trisha, tell us about the thing inside your box. Describe it using descriptive adjectives. O, di ba, bongga? Hindi ka na lang dati nagpapasulat lang ng sentence using an adjective, tapos tapos na, na-assess mo na. O, di ba? So, that is a form of assessment that is really practical and applicable these days. Gusto naman po, lalo na ngayong new normal. So another icebreaker or strategy that you can use for your grade school students is this. So again, I would like to give credit to my St. Paul College Pasig family for doing this and for teaching us these strategies. So the first thing is human check or human cross or human X. So basically, para siyang true or false. Pero for kids, kapag ang answer nila is true, magaganto lang sila, mag-check lang. Check. Tapos, kapag cross naman, pagaganituhin nyo lang sila. Form an X lang using their arms. Yung mga bata, ang cute-cute nila kasi instead of doing an X, ginagawa nilang ganito. So nilalaro nila. Tapos, for example, napakita nyo na yung sentence, true or false. Bibilangan niyo sila. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Show your answer. Then say freeze. O, di ba? May mga bata talaga na magkukupyahan kasi alam niya, nakikita nila yung isa't isa't isa. Ay, kailang yan. So, ayun nga. Yun yung human check or human cross. Tapos, guys, ito nga, kung meron naman kayong way para ma-monitor yung mga camera nila or mga screen nila, nakikita niyo sila sa kabilang side. So, pwede niyo rin gamitin yung thumbs up or thumbs down. So, para rin siyang true or false, pero ano to eh, mas cute na version kasi if they agree, show me two thumbs up. If you do not agree, thumbs down. Tapos, pwede kayong magtanong teachers ng follow-up questions. So, oh, why don't you agree? Bakit ayaw mo? Ganon. Bakit nag-a-agree ka? O, diba? Kaya yung mga namuhula lang or nakikisabay lang, randomly, mag-check nyo kung ano talaga. Kung nakikinig talaga, diba? Or kung nakikigaya lang. Next is Simon Says. So, ito, isa na naman tong icebreakers. Sa icebreaker teachers. So, pag sinabing Simon Says, alam niyo naman na yun eh, no? So, Simon Says, stand up. Simon Says, get your whiteboard. Simon Says, get your notebook. Simon Says, do this. Simon Says, sit down. Ganon. Simon Says, blah, blah, blah. So, pwede yun. Magbigay kayo ng limang Simon Says before your class starts. And I think that will make your students active and awake. Alam niyo, guys, if you're still with me listening while you are sitting down, scrolling your Facebook newsfeed, etc. So while you're doing that and I'm doing this, may share ako sa inyo. So alam nyo ba, pag umaga, ang challenge talaga sa teacher is, paano ko gigisingin yung mga bata? Alam nyo yung nakikita ko sa screen ko na may humihikab-hikab pa, ganun, kasi ramdam ko, antok pa sila. So ang challenge doon is, magpaano ka muna, magpagalaw-galawin mo muna. So, shake your hands on this side, shake your hands like this, stomp your feet. And another creative way to do that is to just say, Simon Says, shake your hands. Teachers, pag naalala na nila yung mga tawag sa strategies, everything will be easier for them to do. Alam niyo yun, matik na yun eh, alam nila. Next is, click the raise hand button. Again, this is one of the less magastos na paraan to keep your students engaged. So, halimbawa, sa Teams, hindi lang actually sa students, eh. Actually, teachers, kayo rin eh, kapag nagpapa-meeting kayo sa mga teachers, no? Tapos when you ask them, if you're still with me, can you please click the raise hand button? O, ang nangyayari niyan, may apat na hindi nag-click ng raise hand button. So, ang next yan, follow-up, some poor girls are still not clicking the raise hand button. Why? Pwedeng ganon. So, tingnan nyo, madidistinguish kasi using the click the raise hand button feature ng mga apps nyo or yung mga LMS nyo kung nakikinig pa sila. So, again, hindi tayo pumunta sa isang website, wala tayong pinagawang tedious task, pero napaalala nyo sa kanila na meron pang teacher na nagsasalita sa harap ng screen. So, next, another icebreaker or another strategy in keeping your students engaged is using these materials. So, show me, show me. Napakahirap na laro ng show me, show me. Pero I like the alliteration. Show me, show me. So, for example, sa first part ng class mo, you ask them, oh, show me your favorite toy. O, diba? Icebreaker na po yun. Show me the nearest object on your right. So, papakita naman nila. So, ang challenge doon, teacher, paano pag naka-off yung camera nila? So, for example, given yung naka-off lahat sila, pero dahil gusto nating i-insist yung strategy na to, gagawin pa rin natin. O, sige, girls, even though your cameras are turned off, let's play show me. Alright, show me your favorite toy. So, bilang ka lang, give them 30 seconds or 1 minute to do it, then ask randomly a girl or a boy to turn on their camera and show what do they have. So, ganun lang. Kahit naka-turn off yung camera nila, pero alam nilang magtatawag ka randomly, kukuha at kukuha ng gamit yan. Next is whiteboard activity. So, you know what? In grade school, it is really important to hone the motor skills of your students. So, ito nga ang challenge. Kasi, since we are not using textbooks anymore, we are creating our own worksheets. We always ask our parents to print the worksheets. If printer is not available, then they have to copy and answer the worksheets on a blank bond paper. So in the same case lang. So to check their handwriting for lower grades, let them use their whiteboard or blackboard. Kung wala talagang gamit, pwede namang notebook, tapos sulatan na lang nila ng kanilang sagot. So, pwede po yun. So again, the first thing is show me, parang ano lang yan, parang scavenger hunt, then whiteboard activity, and ito naman without material to is to let your students type their answer in the comment box. So review lang natin ha, for grade school, we have this, and that. So may idadagdag. So pwede rin kayong mag-play ng sound, and you ask your students, what kind of sound is this? Where is this sound coming from? So with that, you are testing their listening skills. Aside from that, you can also say, read my lips. So parang magsasabi ka ng words, pero without, para kang muted. Then your students will guess what that word is. So you may use it in teaching your students new terms and new words. Another strategy that you can use is zoomed in. So basically, you will show a picture, but for example, picture siya ng kalapate. Hindi yung buong kalapate yung ipapakita mo, pero i-zoom in mo, makikita lang ng student ay yung kuko ng kalapate. May kuko ba yung kalapate? Okay, yung pakpak na lang ng kalapate. Tapos papahula mo sa student mo using the chat box, what is this animal? So pwede rin to sa mga subjects like science, ganun. So ayan na, I hope you will remember these practical icebreakers. Next, for higher levels naman po, guys, I encourage you to use online apps. Since they are adults na, it will be easier for them to transfer from one website to another. And also, when they are required to use online apps, alam niyo yun, mas marami silang gagawin, mas active sila, mas hindi sila passive. So, habang wala ka pang online apps, ito yung mga bagay na pwede mong gamitin. So, alam niyo na to, teachers. So, the first strategy that I have there is two truths and lies. So, pwede mo rin gamitin to. Or two lies, one truth. Pwede mo balik ka rin, nasa sayo yan. O, you ask your student to write three sentences about them. Tapos, yung dalawang sentence dapat totoo, yung isa hindi. On what specific lessons can you use this? So, sa English, ginamit ko to dati in teaching sentence structure. So, hindi ko lang sila pinagsulat ng something about them, but I make sure that the sentence that they are writing is the sentence that they are writing follows the sentence structure that I require them to use. Alright? So, pwede rin to, teachers, sa iba pang subjects. So, pwede nyo siyang i-alter lang para umayon sa inyo pangangailangan. Next activity that you may use is the virtual post box, yung Padlet. So, it will be easier for your students to reply agad or to write their thoughts about your lesson. Pwede to pagkatapos na ng lesson. So, madali na lang for them to share what they have learned using a virtual post box. Also, you may use this app or program to assess if there are any questions needed, yung mga ganun. Next is, for higher levels, you may ask them to share a story. So, this is a bit personal. So, alam niyo yun, pag personal kasi yung atake, mas nagiging engaged talaga yung klase kapag may personal involvement. For example, can you tell us a short story about your parang pinakaluma mong memory? Pwede kang magbigay ng mga ganong speaking prompts. So what else? Can you share a story about your best friend? O ano pa? Paano naman natin siya gagamitin sa ibang subject? So, for example, sa Pilipino, maaari ka bang magkwento ng isang bagay na pinakamatagal nang nasa'yo? Sa science naman, pwede niyo silang pag-researchin online tungkol sa isang science outbreak, parang ganun, science trivia na pwede nilang i-share sa class. Okay? When they share a story, it's like they're sharing news. So, for example, sa Araling Panlipunan, Social Studies, you can ask your students to share some news and present it to the class. So basically, when you are asking the students to do this and that, then you are just nagiging facilitator ka na lang ng learning. Well, hindi naman siya lang, kasi you are the facilitator of learning and your class is becoming more student-centered. Tapos, another thing is you may use the guess the giverish thing. Alam niyo yun, yung sa Instagram, meron kasi parang ano doon. Merong laro doon na parang meron kang word na hugulaan pero yung spelling mali. So, pwede rin to pang-activate lang ng ano yun, ng happy hormones ng mga estudyante before your class starts. So, ayan. Naniniwala ako na marami na kayong nakita ng apps online sa mga previous webinar. Pero sa lahat ng to, ang pinaka-favorite kong isi-share sa inyo ay joinmyquiz.com. So, joinmyquiz.com, this is not a sponsored post anyway. So, joinmyquiz.com is like Kahoot na pwede kang magpa-answer sa mga bata ng games pero related sa lesson mo. Tapos, pwede nyo siyang sagutan ng sabay-sabay. Makikita mo kung sino yung may pinakamataas na score. Then, sa student part naman, kapag mabilis siyang sumagot, mas mataas yung score niya. So, you already know how it works. You just have to explore it. So, join my quiz. Parang ano lang din yan, kahoot.com. Yung Padlet naman, virtual postdocs. Yung menti.com, gusto. Alam na alam nyo na yan. So, you just have to explore those things. So, before I end my talk about keeping your students engaged, so, gusto ko itong iwan sa inyo. So, katulad nga ng sinabi ko kaninang umaga, more than the technology that we are using, your personality as a teacher matters most. Students do not care how much you know until they know how much you care. So, sometimes it's not about what we know, but it's about how we care for our students. So, pag nilayan natin mga teachers, no, dapat ba natin ilagay lang yung sarili natin sa box na kailangan kong gawin to, kailangan kong gawin yan? Baka naman teachers, nasasobrahan na tayo sa preparation, tapos nakakalimutan na natin yung dating self natin as a teacher. So, always, always remember your identity as a teacher. Then, when you already remember that, that's the time that you plan your lessons. So again, lahat po nung narinig natin ay pawang mga suggestions lamang. Nasa sa inyo pa rin po if you're gonna use it or not. So teachers, again, remember, you are capable to teach and you are capable to empathize. And please remember that you are capable to care. So, hindi po recollection ang inatinan nyo kung hindi isa na namang webinar mula sa Vival. So, should you have any questions, teachers, please type your comments sa ating chat box.
Hi, Ma. We have questions here po from our viewers po.
Sige po.
Basahin ko na lang po sa inyo. First question mo from Miss Dina Tesorio.
What is the ideal number of pupils po in an online class? Is it okay to record an online class for a bigger number of pupils? If that, so how can I record their recitation?
Ah, okay. Thank you po, teacher, for that question. No? So you had two questions. What is the ideal number? The ideal number talaga ay nanggagaling talaga sa ating mga heads. So in our case, the ideal number is 15 students per online class since the 15 students for an online class are kids. Pero sa higher level, I think we can handle 30 students kasi malalaki naman na sila. But the thing is, tama po yung tanong nyo, how do we record our students' recitation? So ako po kasi, traditional po ako, I always keep my class record near me whenever I conduct online lessons. So meron akong list ng mga pangalan nila. So for every recitation that they do, for every answers that they post in the comment box, chine-check ko kaagad, nilalagyan ko talaga agad ng description kung ano yung sagot nila. So the third thing about recording the class, we are in our school po, we are not allowed to record our online class for data privacy na rin po. Also teacher, when we record the video of our class, malaking file po yun and it will consume a space in our laptop. Pero kung malaki naman po, pero hindi eh. Huwag nyo na lang pong i-record. For me po, isulat nyo na lang po. So yun po, Miss Michelle.
Thank you po. Next po is from Mr. Aaron Delgado. Ma'am, good AM po. As pa lang po in public school, the setting and idea is only supervision and monitoring and most of the time, flipped learning process ang may-utilize. May way po ba kayo or tayo kung paano po kaya magagamit or ma-apply ang learnings na ito? Salamat po.
Okay, ayan nga po yung sinasabi ko kanina, Ms. Michelle, ano? What I have shared earlier is for online synchronous classes. Pero in the case of public school, ang nakikita kong solution dyan for this ganito is we can integrate the strategies or the learning by setting rules and regulation pa lang sa pagbibigay natin ng module. So siguro po teachers in public schools, mas naiintindihan niyo po yung situation and maybe you can meet with your other public school co-teachers para makapag-plan ng way on how to integrate this. So basically, I am not an expert po about how to do it in public. Ms. Michelle.
Thank you po ma'am. Next question po is from Ma'am Francis. How about the slow learners in class? How can we arouse his or her willingness to actively participate in online class in fact that they even don't know or cope up with the given lessons you presented?
Ayun po ang isa ring challenge sa online learning kasi hindi talaga lahat ng bata pare-pareho ng learning pace. So ano yung pwede nating gawin? Pwede nating gamitin yung differentiated instruction. So maybe we can prepare different set of materials that we can give to our students. If this child is more visual, then maybe we can give some things na mas interesado siya. So after your online synchronous class, maybe you can give her more things to do. Para alam niyo po yun, the more responsibilities that he has, then mas marerequire siya to do it. And of course, we need to collaborate with the parents of the students so they can always guide. Kasi ang kaya lang nating gawin is to motivate them extrinsically and intrinsically. We should always collaborate pa rin with the parents.
Thank you for Ms. Kim. And then the last question for Ms. Marisa Pantoja. How can you show empathy to our learners at home?
Ayan. Sobrang, actually, teacher, sa nagtanong nito, ang pagpapakita ng empathy, hindi lang siya sa student. Hindi lang siya para sa student. ang pagpapakita, i-add ko lang ah, ang pagpapakita ng empathy ay para din sa ating fellow teachers, sa mga kasama sa bahay. So basically, empathy is a universal thing. So for the question, paano natin mapapakita yung empathy sa mga students? Kanina, katulad ng sinabi ko, sa first 5 minutes pa lang, you let your students feel that you are an authentic person. So, hindi ka namalastic, pero you are telling them na, I am your second parent. O diba, second parent ka na despite of all the challenges, no? Sa likod ng online learning na hindi nila nakikita. So, ulit. So, let your students know that you are always there for them. You are ready to listen. We are not required to give an advice, but the least thing that we can do is to listen to them. And for me, that is the easiest way on how can we show empathy to our students. Yes, Ms. Michelle?
That's all we have the question for now, ma'am. So, do you have any last reminders to our viewers po?
Okay po. For the last reminders po, so, balikan ko lang po yung last quotes ko. So, dear teachers, again, more than the technology, your personality matters most. The way you care, the way you show your empathy to your students, that matters. Because students do not care how much you know until they know how much you care. So, despite of all these online learning challenges, please teachers, don't forget to care for your students. And of course, before you care for your students, please take care of yourself first. So, ayan, promote ko lang po. Please like my Facebook page, Kimberla, and please read my blog post on kimberla.com. And if you want a copy of my PowerPoint, I can share it with you. Just send me an email, kimberla@gmail.com. Thank you, Ms. Michelle. Thank you.